In this video, I'm going to show you the best sequence settings for Premiere Pro when you're creating Instagram Reels. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So I'm inside Adobe Premiere Pro and I have two video clips. And to showcase the difference here, I have both a horizontal video clip as you can see here and a vertical video clip as well. Now, if you shoot vertical on your phone and you want to edit in Premiere Pro, the easiest way to create a sequence is to simply click and drag the clip from the project panel to the timeline window. This will create a new sequence based on the video clip settings. And since it's already vertical, you don't have to worry about trying to create a custom vertical sequence. It will do it for you. If you need to make adjustments for the resolution or the frame rate, you can easily go up to sequence settings. This will display your resolution here. So just make sure this says 1080 and that the vertical says 1920. Also double check that this says square pixels and that no fields are selected for the fields. And by default, Instagram supports 29 frames a second. So just make sure that 29 frames a second is selected and you should be good to go. If you work on an iPhone, I would recommend checking on this box right here. Just make sure this is checked auto tone map media. This will convert your HDR footage into normal looking footage when it's inside your sequence here. Once you're good, you can click OK. Now, it's not always the case that you work with vertical videos. Sometimes you shoot horizontally and you want to take that horizontal video and fit it into a vertical sequence. I'm going to show you how to do that next. So for example here, our first clip is horizontal. But we know Instagram Reels only supports vertical type of videos. So how do you take this horizontal video clip and make it vertical? To do that, you have to create a custom sequence. So to do that, go up to File, New, Sequence. And then if you're on the latest version of Premiere Pro, they updated the presets window. If you twirl down under social, you'll notice that there's a social media portrait option here. I would recommend choosing this if it's available. This will automatically create a vertical sequence for you. So if you click OK, you'll notice that you have a blank vertical timeline created inside Premiere Pro. Now, if that isn't an option for you, you can easily go over to the Settings tab. So just to show you, if you go to File, New Sequence, and you go to the Settings tab, you can manually type in 1080 next to the frame size for horizontal and 1920 for vertical. So I'm going to click OK. And with our new sequence created, one thing you have to do is resize the footage to make it vertical. So next, I'm going to click and drag out our horizontal clip into our vertical timeline. And you'll notice this window pop up. What I recommend doing is just clicking on this button, Keep Existing Settings, because remember, we set up this vertical sequence setting. We don't want to revert it back to horizontal. So we'll just click this. And that way, it puts this horizontal video clip inside this vertical sequence. So now what we can do is click on our clip and go over to Effects Controls, this window right here. If you don't see this, you can go up to Window Effects Controls and you can manually scale this up. Now, if you're on the latest version of Premiere Pro, I do recommend changing your workspace to vertical. So if you go up to the Workspaces button, you can go to Vertical. This will just display your vertical video a little bit better here. So you'll notice that our subject is off-center to the right and you can manually adjust this by adjusting the position. But a cool effect that you can use is called auto reframe inside Premiere Pro. This will automatically track the subject throughout your video clip and keep them center in the frame. To apply auto reframe, navigate to your effects panel. If you don't see this, you can go up to Window Effects and type in for auto reframe. You can double click to apply it to the clip or click and drag it to your clip. And now when you click play, you'll notice that it analyzes the footage and it keeps the person center in the frame, even though that they are navigating from one side of the video to the other. So that's how to adjust horizontal clips inside a vertical timeline inside Premiere Pro. Now, if you want to learn about export settings for Instagram Reels, I do recommend checking out my video going over that. I'll link that one right up there. But that does it for this video. Let me know if you have any questions, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.